Now student, let us come to the next program of your plotting. Okay, next program of the plotting. So see this one. So this is the thing what you have done. We have done. I have done here plotting of the particular format, plotting of the particular structure. Now I will going to do another pattern of graph where you will going to see here how the line has been executed. Now let us okay. So how the line has been executed? See here, I have called here math plot. Okay. So before going to that, let us do the another one. Let us do this one. So this is what, see here, this is a single phase. I have used here a single phase line graph. So the all the requirement has been given. Let us run the program and see what it is going to give us. In this particular scenario, what the output is going to give us. Let us see the output as we find, see here. Okay, previously you have seen the output, that the output is what? That the output has been half graphed here. Have you seen this output? This is the output. What you find it, that this particular output of the previous program where we have done the plotting in a different way in a line graph. Now this is the graph where we find it that you can do the plotting in the phase where you have started. Now 5 and 2. So this is the 2 and this is the 5. From 5 and 2 what has been done? Then 2 and 16. So this is the point of 2, then this is 16, and after that 7 and 4. Then from here where it came to this part. This is the 7 and this is the 4 line. If you draw the line in the graph sheet, you will find those are the meeting points. So how it has gone? It has gone like a triangular shape. So half triangular shape or full triangular shape you can form the line graph as by your declaration. That means how you have given the declaration. Here what I have given? I have given only the title of it. That means plot what to plot x and y. So it has plotted x and y. What to give here? First the title. Title has given the info. Then y level has been given x-axis. That means this is an x-axis, so you may have confusion. So this is your y-axis and this is your x-axis. Okay, x level has been given and an x-axis. So this is your x-axis, this is the y-axis. So these are the different two structure that you find it that has been done and that has been plotted in this particular scenario. This is the scenario what has been the output of this one, and this was the output of the previous one. Why I have brought here, you see how the thing has been done. From here you can get the clear idea what to give and where to give. This is your particular title of the graph. This is your y-axis. So I have written here y-axis. See here very clearly, this is the y-axis and this is the x-axis. Now here I have used only a single x and y phase to draw a graph. But here what has been done, two different segments or two different line has been taken to draw the line graph in a particular one single graph sheet. So this is how you can draw the graph and you can execute your graph. Now executing the graph, there are the many ways of executing the graph. There are the bar graph, there are the dots graph, there are the triangular graph. So different pattern of graph format is there. Those the dots, you can change the dot format. Dot lines can be given, triangles can be given. So all these things are there, different type of implementations are there. So it is expected that you should implement those things, those implementations in your graph, in the line graph, in this particular format what I am showing you. That line graph I have shown you only on the base of line, but you can change them in a different type of format and you can implement them in the different type of format of your line graph. So this is how you can implement it. Another more thing that is to be highlighted here, that you know those the axis, as I am moving the cursor, you see the axis point of the x and y is changing. So as soon as the x and y is changing, that means you